So, Pap, obviously a big story this week. One of the biggest is the continued investigation into this Chris Christie scandal. We're seeing more investigations opened up on different fronts, ranging from the New Jersey state legislature to we're starting to see federal investigations. We're now starting to see an IG investigation into the use of Sandy, the Superstorm Sandy funds that the Christie administration had. And this is not going to go away.
No. You know what I think is funny about it? It's just so poetic. You know, you have the Tea Party fringe. They just can't get that image of Christie hugging Obama out of their spooky little heads. So now the clearinghouse of cuckoos, I mean, people like Limbaugh and Levin and Beck and Malzberg, well, they have both the Christie bridge traffic scam and the Sandy Storm money hustle that's done by Christie to turn up their personal attack machine. And so, so you're seeing these talking points. They're perfect. I mean, they are perfect for the Tea Party demagogues like Beck, who's now telling his kind of his hateful little bunch of tea toads that Christie's a Nixon-like thug who uses government to punish his enemies, which is true. But it's
right.
It's just fun to hear those kind of words originating in Beck's little oddball brain.
Well, I mean, there are so many different cross currents here. You know, part of the scandal is that you had sort of party bosses, Democrats in the New Jersey state protecting Christie because he did them favors. But you're also seeing, you know, some of the first reactions that we saw on a national level were coming from people like Rand Paul. We're coming from people like Lindsey Graham. We're seeing a cross section of attacks on Christie. And, you know, make no mistake about it. This is not because this guy is some type of moderate that the extremes have a problem with. The fact is that he's incredibly corrupt. All of the criticism is instructive. But it is fascinating to watch the right wing attack him for this type of corruption. Now, we also should note that there's another part of the Republican machine that is actually coming to Christie's aid simply because they perceive him as not being a Democrat. You got guys like Britt Hume going on there and saying the only reason why Chris Christie is having any problems is because the country's been so feminized that they don't appreciate how manly Chris Christie is. I mean, it's just bizarre.
You know, the part of the story, there's so many parts of this. As this develops, it's becoming so evident. Here it is. You had the hedge fund guys, the Wall Street hedge fund guys, a lot of them huge, huge Democrat donors. I mean, give big money to Democrats that have been behind Chris Christie because they know that he is just this lug, this big old lug that's going to do anything they ask him to do. I mean, look, just in his terms, he gave, what, $2 billion worth of tax breaks his first within his first year, his first term. So all of a sudden now what we have is we have all of those Wall Street Democrats that are heavily behind him, the Podesta types, and then you have the Koch brothers. Well, I think one of the Koch brothers said that this is a man who's an inspiration to him and that he's just one of America's finest leaders. So they had all this money lined up behind this guy. And the question is, can he weather? Yeah, he could weather the bridge issue probably till we find out, which you and I know is that he's lying. I mean,
right,
he might even be able to weather the lie. But this issue with the issue with the Sandy Storm issue is becoming uglier and uglier by the day.
Well, I got to tell you,
they're scrambling.
Pat,
yeah,
I think the question now is not whether or not he is a viable candidate in 2016. I think the question is whether or not he's still governor in 2015. Mm. I mean, there was a Pew poll that came out this week asking how many people are paying attention. And Pew, I think oddly in their in the headlining of this poll, basically said that people aren't paying attention to this, but I'm sorry. I mean, even their own numbers, you've got nearly 40% of the country who's paying close attention to this story. That's stunning. You don't have 40% of the people who pay attention to any story in this country. And
less
of those people,
Kardashians.
Among those people who are following the story very much or fairly closely, 29% have a less favorable view of this guy. 57% their opinion hasn't changed yet. You still have 11%. Of course, those are the sort of the George Bush was the greatest president ever, dead enders. So this is really, really poisoned the well for Chris Christie. And people should note, this isn't merely a political story. This is a criminal one.
Yeah,
we don't
that's
know.
That's what everybody's missing. This is a criminal story. And the point is, I'm not so sure it's going to affect. I mean, he's going to be, I think, able to weather his term. I think what to me, though, that we know the dynamics of a story like this.
Yes.
You already have kind of those little the pimps, the little political pimps that just are hangers on. They come out of college. They don't have a job. So they attach themselves to some no count politician and follow that politician's career. It is those characters who are getting caught up in all this. And those little characters, when the pressure starts coming on them about obstruction of justice and interfering with police investigations and perjury, when that starts happening, they start jumping ship, and I think that's already started happening. I don't know if you followed this end of it, Sam. One thing we're seeing happening is we're seeing this push to say nobody cares about this story, A, as you pointed out,
right.
And B, people are tired of the story. Well, let me just tell you, the story has just started. So
that's correct.
They can be tired all they want, but this story's not going away.
Yeah, and that's why I say, you know, that's the distinction there. This is going to have political implications, but the narrative of this story is going to be driven by criminal investigations that no amount of Christie scandal fatigue will impact.
No, I mean
people are going to get to the bottom of this. We're going to know who those redacted people are in those conversations. We're going to find out at the end of the day. I mean, there's a bunch of different theories floated out there as to whether this was retribution or about a real estate development. Those things will be resolved. But at the end of the day, we know the basic dynamic here. And I don't know how hard people are willing to fall on the sword for Chris Christie
they won't.
For his non-presidential ambitions.